every faculty, everything that can theoretically be pronounced as philosophy, that which removes the person from the hurdles of suspicion, oblivion, false apprehension, and deception, and various other productive measures and other byproducts which enter into the path of illusion. That which is said to be so, that is worthy enough to be called as knowledge, and philosophy is the study of pursuit of such a knowledge, which is all knowledge. So, third comes to religion. Religion is an area where there is a code of conduct and principle which attributes the person to a pathway, that is, having a particular theoretical approach and also a conviction about the fundamental reality, that is, the tattva, the means for attainment of the fundamental reality and realization, that is, the Gita, and the fruits of the realization and dissipation as Purusha. So, as per the definition given by the ancient Matasthapatas, the primordial receptors of our transcendental philosophical schools and standards, they clearly carved and culminated the level of perfection to religion. Even though that is misinterpreted, misconceived and malpracticed, religion is the highest standard of order, and religion gives you proximity to God. Spiritualism, it is in a remote sensory perception value, and philosophy that has intensive perception value and proximate and particularly perception value is with religion. So spiritualism is the way of understanding the imperceptible, the Brahman or supreme reality, and philosophy is a source of knowledge which combines various types of approaches. For example, philosophy, it has five major divisions. There are more than 630 divisions of philosophy. There are five major divisions. One is ontology, the study towards the fundamental concept of each and every behavior and each and every structure. That is ontology. Epistemology, the study of origin, evolution, expansion, and evolution or retransformation of wisdom. Epistemology. Metaphysics, that which deals with the exposure and experience of that which is unscrutable and impalpable to human limited sensory organs or limited intellect and perceptible value. That is epistemology. Then the fourth thing is cosmology, the study of evolution of the world. That is evolution, the sustenance by means of rotation and revolution in axis and orbit. Then getting into dissolution, in which it is converted into a microcosmic enzyme. So in Vishishtadvaita, Vishishtasya Brahmana Advaitam Vishishtadvaitam, in our philosophy, we used to call the Vishishta Brahman, the super sentient being embedded and embellished with the sentient and insentient being, the Chetana Chetana Vishishta Brahman. At the time of emancipation, at the time of emanation as well as expansion, it is Stula Chidadit Vishishta Brahman. It is tangible and it is macrocosmic. At the time of dissolution, it is becoming microcosmic. So, the microcosmic and macrocosmic exposure, which deals with the hot and cold dark matter synthesis and primordial synthesis of the Riemannian zebra, as well as the Big Bang conjecture, is being explained by Vishishtadvaita Siddhanta in the form of Stula Chidadit Vishishta Brahma and Sukshma Chidadit Vishishta Brahma, the macrocosmic and microcosmic inheritation of the Supreme, the ultimate reality. So, here, it is explained in cosmology. And the fifth is eschatology. We deal with the interval. Human life is nothing but the interval between his life and death. Then eschatology is a science which perceives the second interval between his death and rebirth. That which deals with the process of transmigration. That which believes the perpetual cycle of transmigration, where there is a time immemorial causal relation which puts them into effect, and the effect being cause of a second cyclic cause. So, this perpetual arrangement of mutual law, reliability, liability and responsibility of the karmic body is studied in eschatology. So, the philosophy in higher standard, it deals with cosmology, eschatology, metaphysics, epistemology and ontology. So, this is known as philosophy. And I was very much confused about this subject. And it has been clearly mentioned that it is on Indian thought. Because philosophy is a science which deals with imperceptibility, and the physics gravity that deals with the behavior of mutual annihilation or attitude of mutual attraction that exists between particles, massive particles. So, this everything can be combined in a sense of primordial approach or ultimate approach, that is entirely different. Taking into consideration the proximate values or peripheral or apparent approach, it is very difficult to mingle both these things. Philosophy, generally Indian philosophy, philosophy means Vedanta. The essence of Veda, what we call is philosophy. Philosophy generally refers to Vedanta, as per the Indian tradition and lineage. In the vast sense, vaster sense and vaster sense, we can see three different types of philosophy. In vast sense, it deals with the five schools of thought and the five disciplines of thought which I have clearly depicted now. And in the vaster sense, it covers the six schools of thought. One is the Nayayika, the logistic school of thought, as founded by Gautama. Second is the Vaisheshika Shastra, which is elucidated by Anada. There is a qualified mechanism or quantum mechanism in which he put the Paramanuvada. The Paramanuvada, that is the theory of the atomic base or nuclear base, that is the first atomic theory, was founded only by Vaisheshika Kanada, not by Dalton. And the first model had been depicted only by him, not by the Bohr's atomic model, which is very much popular in our physics class. So, it is the Kanada school of thought which deals with the atomic and subatomic theory, Anu and Paramanuvada. The third thing is the Sankhya or the epistemological survey, which Sankhya Buddhi Dhyana. So, he deals with this. The Sankhya philosophy, which is a communion of Pradhana and Purusha, matter with Purusha, the individual, being responsible for the cosmic function, which is given by Kapilacharya. Then came the Yoga school of thought of Patanjali, in which there is an Ishwara, Tasya Vachapranamaha. So says Patanjali, there is a controller, there is a supercomputer and master brain, and the hyper mind behind this control of this universe, it is not accidental, incidental, coincidental, collective, individual or something else. So it is properly manipulated, managed, administered by the hyper-sentient force acting on it. So that is the Seshwara Yogavada of Patanjali. Then came the two major schools of thought, one Purva Mimamsa of Jaimini, which deals with the ritualistic portions of application. Then came the Uttara Mimamsa of Vadarayana and Krishnadvaitaya Vyasa, which is now popularly known as Vedanta philosophy, which is commented by all Madhacharyas, like Vaskaracharya, Yadav Prakashacharya, Ramanuja, Vantabha, Nibbarja, Swaminarayana, Shankaracharya, Madhvacharya, in the terms of that respective philosophies, known as Shuddhadvaita, Bhavadvaita, Tattvadvaita, Dvaitadvaita, Achitya Vedadvaita, Vedadvaita, Vishishtadvaita, Dvaita, etc. So this is in vaster sense. The vastest sense of philosophy is into the philosophy of Bertrand Russell, Immanuel Kant, which are most probably their non-theistic as well as atheistic principles, or even the theistic principles of great scholars like Immanuel Kant, etc. And even the philosophy that existed in our country, Charvaka. Then the Jaina philosophy, which is known as Arhata, and four schools of thought of Buddhism known as Vaibhashika, Sautrantika, Madhyamika, and Yogacharya. Apart from which, there is Bhatta and Prabhakara, two schools of thought, and also the Pashupata, which is belonging to the Pashupati tradition or Shaiva tradition, which is now found in the forms of Siddha, Shaiva, Kathalika, Balaramka, and Jaini philosophy. So, in broader sense of Eastern and Western philosophy, it is said to be the encompassment of all types of philosophy, Eastern and Western, Vedic, non-Vedic, theistic and atheistic. So it covers everything that tries to defend and depend upon the principles of knowledge about the primordial universe, the origin of the soul and the destination, and the causative factor which has combined these various things and who has arranged it, whether it is existing or not, is it accessible or not, is it within us or not, is it ourselves or somebody else, is it attainable here or somewhere else? Dehantrava, Dehantrava. Atmanyantrava, Bhaktiva. So there are lots of such philosophical discussions going on. So a national seminar on this Indian philosophical systems and gravity has two major functions. One, it must cover all these various areas. In the second session, no doubt we are going to conduct the same subject with more elucidated problems and solutions, perceptions given by various approaches of various people, with a great concourse and with more valuable discourses. No doubt, this inaugural, I am not only inaugurating this seminar, I am inaugurating a series of seminars on the same subject as well as a series of subjects on various disciplines throughout the globe for the dissemination of ultimate knowledge throughout. So it may have a small beginning, like a forest fire, but it will have its own blazing consequences in dissemination of knowledge and eradication of the murky.